The B-21 Raider is a cutting-edge US long-range stealth strategic bomber capable of penetrating the latest anti-air defenses and destroying targets far into enemy territory. It's described as the world's first sixth-generation aircraft, and Australia has the opportunity to be part of it. Production on the bomber has already started, and it's due to come into service with the United States Air Force in 2027. Several Australian organisations have said this would be a good buy for us, and senior US officials have expressed that they are open to the idea of Australia buying them. But what exactly is the B-21 Raider, and what can it do? How much will they cost, and should Australia actually buy them? I'm Mel Pikos, and today we're talking tactics. The Indo-Pacific region to Australia's north is hotting up at an alarming rate. China is undertaking the biggest warship building program since the Second World War and illegally claiming parts of the South China Sea where they are building military bases. In February 2025, a flotilla of Chinese warships circumnavigated Australia, coming within 150 nautical miles of Sydney. And President Xi has told the People's Liberation Army to be ready for an invasion of Taiwan in 2027. Australia's main deterrent against Chinese aggression to our north are the planned nuclear-powered submarines to be delivered under the AUKUS program. But the first of the Virginia-class subs isn't scheduled to reach Australia until the early 2030s. There are also significant shortfalls occurring in US submarine industry at the moment, meaning that it's likely that it'll be even longer before Australia gets that first Virginia sub. With the rapid escalation of tension in our region, every year counts. So is there another option which would allow Australia to have a long-range strike capability which could deter China from interfering with our shipping lanes to our north? An option that could potentially be operational by 2030? The B-21 Raider is that option. What is the B-21? The Northrop Grumman B-21 Raider is America's latest stealth strategic bomber. Developed as part of the Long Range Strike Bomber program, it is designed to be able to deliver both conventional and nuclear weapons. The advanced stealth elements of the aircraft make it difficult to detect and engage, even when flying over enemy territory, enabling it to deliver strikes deep behind enemy lines. The Long Range Strike Bomber program began in 2011, with Northrop Grumman being awarded the development contract in 2015. The final design was completed in 2018, and by 2019, construction on the first plane was underway at the United States Air Force Plant 42, in California. In 2020, the design was first revealed to the public, and the first test flight of the B-21 took place on the 10th of November, 2023. By 2024, low-rate initial production had started, with 100 aircraft planned to be built, although it's widely speculated that this might increase to 150 or 200 as time goes by. The US Air Force is currently expected to have the B-21 in service by 2027, and by 2040, it will have replaced both the B-1 and B-2 strategic bombers. Specifications. Many aspects of the B-21 are still classified, so the specs that we're going to talk about may be incomplete or based on estimates, so keep that in mind as we go through the numbers. The B-21 has a crew of 2. It has a length of 16 meters, a wingspan of 40 meters, and its maximum takeoff weight is 81 tons. The top speed of the aircraft is about 1,000 kilometers per hour, or Mach 0.8, and it has a maximum operating ceiling of 15,000 meters. It is estimated that the B-21 can carry up to 9 tons of ordnance in its weapons bay. The range of the B-21 hasn't been made clear yet, but it's widely estimated to be over 9,000 kilometers, which is about 10 times the range of a Super Hornet when it's fitted out for a strike mission. Of course, the most impressive thing about the B-21 is its cutting-edge stealth capabilities, sensors, and avionics packages. Given how classified all this technology still is, we don't know the specifics about its abilities, but it's estimated that the stealth capabilities of the B-21 are much better than the F-35. Importantly, it doesn't require other crewed aircraft for support on strike missions, so no air-to-air refuelers, fighter escorts, and no need for electronic attacked aircraft for suppression and air defense. Australia and the B-21. The potential for Australia to acquire a squadron of B-21s has been thrown around for the past couple of years. In 2022, the Australian Strategic Policy Institute advocated for Australia to acquire a squadron in order to have a long-range strike capability. Also in 2022, during bilateral talks between Australia and the US, then US Air Force Secretary Frank Kendall said, in relation to the idea of Australia acquiring B-21s, "I don't think that there's any fundamental limitation on the areas in which we can cooperate. If Australia had a requirement for long-range strike, then we'd be willing to have a conversation with them about that." However, in 2023, the Defence Strategic Review stated that the B-21 was not a suitable option for consideration for acquisition. The Australian government said it would instead focus on upgrading and upgunning the F-35s and FA-18F Super Hornets with new weapons, even though neither of these aircraft or their new weapons have anywhere near the range of the B-21. Some groups continue to push for Australia to acquire the B-21 though. In August 2024, the Institute of Public Affairs released a paper recommending the Australian government reconsider its position on the aircraft, stating that it would provide a long-range strike capability if the AUKUS program experienced delays. Australia's strike aircraft capability. Long-range strike capabilities are important in holding potential enemies at arm's length. If you have the ability to destroy their ships and bases at a range of thousands of kilometers, it means that a potential adversary is less likely to use military force to try to coerce you. Specifically for Australia, this sort of military coercion might take the form of interfering with the shipping lanes to our north, establishing bases within closer striking range of Australia, or trying to physically isolate us from our allies. And given that there's supply constraints on our ability to refuel, this is of vital importance to keep Australia moving. Australia hasn't had much of a long-range strike capability since we retired the F-111s in 2010. The F-111 had a maximum range of about 6,000 kilometers, but was replaced by the Super Hornets, which only have a range of 3,000 kilometers. The nuclear submarines Australia will acquire under AUKUS are an ultimate long-range strike capability. We would be able to place these boats essentially anywhere in the world and launch a wide variety of missiles from them. The only issue is that even under current AUKUS timeframes, we aren't scheduled to receive our first Virginia-class nuclear sub until sometime in the early 2030s. With the USA's submarine production capability currently running at about half what they need to be just to maintain their own force, it's looking more and more likely that there are going to be some significant delays in receiving our submarines. The B-21 would provide a much longer ranged, more stealthy, and more lethal strike option than the FA-18F, and would be delivered more quickly than the AUKUS submarines. Should Australia acquire the B-21? Part of the problem with these recently announced big defense projects, like AUKUS, is that they sound great, but don't actually deliver additional capabilities for a decade or more. We're in a strategic situation where every year counts, and we need projects which can be delivered on time and within the next few years. The 2022 report from the Australian Strategic Policy Institute estimated that the total acquisition cost of a fleet of 12 B-21s would be between 25 and 28 billion Australian dollars. This is less than a tenth of what Australia would be spending on the AUKUS nuclear submarine program, and will provide a long-range strike capability to Australia much sooner. The report estimates that Australia could have several B-21s delivered and operational by 2030 or by 2032 at the latest. With America's aircraft production not experiencing the same sort of supply issues affecting their shipbuilding industry, this seems very achievable. While spending another 20-something billion on defense over the next few years sounds daunting, it's very doable. Australia currently spends about 50 billion, or a bit less than 2% of gross domestic product on defense per year. If we were to spend an extra $5 billion per year on the B-21s over the next few years, this would increase our defense spending to about 2.2% of GDP. This might sound like a lot, and for comparison, during the Cold War era, Australia on average spent almost 3% of its GDP on defense. Arguably, we're now in a worse strategic situation than we were during the Cold War, so spending this feels more justified to me, particularly because it's an issue that is affecting our region. So is buying a small fleet of B-21s worth it for Australia? In my opinion, it absolutely is. We'd be able to acquire and have these aircraft operational within a few years, giving Australia a potent long-range strike capability in the near term and increasing our ability to deter adversaries from making aggressive moves toward us. It would also take a bit of pressure off the AUKUS program, as delays in submarine deliveries wouldn't mean that Australia was completely without a long-range strike ability during this time. And when the AUKUS subs are delivered, Australia would have two long-range strike capabilities, giving the ADF more options and flexibility in the way that it deters aggression in our region. Australia has operated strike aircraft at the same time as operating submarines before, with the F-111 being in service at the same time as the Oberon and then Collins-class submarines. We can do it again. What do you think about the B-21 Raider? Should Australia acquire these to restore our long-range strike capability and take the pressure off the AUKUS program? Should we buy more than 12? Or do you think that they're not needed at all, even though our strategic environment is deteriorating? I'd love to see your thoughts in the comments section down below. Don't forget to hit that like button if you enjoyed the video, and make sure you subscribe so you don't miss the next video. Thanks very much to SPAC.au for supplying these models, and if you're interested in getting some of your own, Talking Tactics viewers can get 5% off the camouflage models. They've got a great range of 3D printed models here. We've actually got a few more already ordered, and I can't wait to add them to our shelf right here. So use my link in the description below to check out SPAC.au and get your 5% off. But that's it for today. I'm Mel Pikos, and we've been talking tactics.